fantastic but useless.
I'm really excited about teaming up with you.
Scarlett Johansson calling out Sam Altman.
The Department of Justice is calling for the breakup of Google.
TikTok could now be banned in the U.S.
Even that hawk!
Google!
What is a photo?
Blue screen of death.
Okay, hold up. That was all last year. Here at The Verge, we like to focus on the future. So we asked the reporters to tell us their predictions for 2025.
My pick is more advanced health features and FDA clearances. So the big thing in wearable and health tech is this very slow race toward advanced medical adjacent features. Let's face it, on the hardware front, health and fitness wearables have gotten pretty good. It's just battery life and tweaks to screens going forward. So to differentiate themselves, I think you're gonna see companies really dive in on pursuing FDA cleared features. This year, Apple and Samsung introduced sleep apnea detection, and Google had loss of pulse detection on the Pixel Watch 3. On the more niche side, Dexcom and Abbott both released over-the-counter continuous glucose monitors for type 2 diabetics who don't use insulin and non-diabetics. The thing all this tech has in common is it's meant to flag potential health issues before they become big problems. And while this isn't a new trend, you're going to see companies doubling or even tripling down on this particular frontier. And with all the recent buzz around AI, I think you're also going to see companies going a bit deeper with AI fitness, health, diet suggestions, or even chatbots built within the app. Basically, anything to get you wearing devices 24/7 and obsessing over a continuous stream of health metrics.
Physical keys, your days are numbered. Smart door locks are one of the simplest, most compelling smart home devices. They make it easy for you to get into your home without having to carry a key, let other people in at any time without being there, and give you a host of new ways to control your door. This year saw the launch of dozens of new smart locks featuring a myriad of smarter ways to control the door, from keypads, fingerprint readers, and Apple's Home Key, to one lock that uses your face as the key. But next year will be the year of the smart lock, thanks to a new standard being developed by Apple, Google, Samsung, and all the major lock makers called Aliro. Using NFC and UWB technologies, Aliro, which means access in Esperanto, will make your phone, watch, or similar device be a key for your front door. So you can just tap to unlock like you tap to pay. Apple already has this in its iPhones and Apple Watches on some locks, but with Aliro, this tech will quickly become mainstream and even extend beyond the home to places like your office and gym. So we can finally dump those physical keys.
Game-changing AI features.
Apple intelligence can unlock even more intelligence.
Generative AI at the scale of human curiosity.
We heard all about AI in 2024. Every smartphone maker told us that their AI smartphones were going to change everything. And right now we have notification summaries, robots can write your email, and you can make pictures of your food look disgusting. So, no, I don't think we're there yet. The thing is, I think AI could really change how we use our phones, but it needs to prove itself, and 2025 is really going to be a do or die moment. Apple's smarter Siri will get new abilities in 2025 so it can actually do things for you. And Samsung keeps saying it's going to make Bixby a thing finally, so maybe we'll see that in the S25 series. And then Google has AI everywhere, all over its phones, and maybe 2025 will be the year that Gemini can pull it all together. That's a lot of maybes, so there's obviously still a lot to prove. We need to find out if hallucination's gonna be a big problem. We don't know if these features are gonna be locked behind subscription fees. And we just don't know if AI can do everything that these phone makers are hoping it can do. They've been talking a big game, but AI needs to actually show up in 2025. Because I think people are going to start losing patience, and I know I will.
For a generation, the world is largely run on Windows PCs with Intel inside. It's such a dominant duo, the phrase Wintel was coined. While Intel rival AMD sometimes manages to break 20% market share, Intel has never given up the lead. But now, Wintel is under fire from practically every direction. Apple and Qualcomm have finally scaled their phone chips into real competition in the laptop space with unheard-of battery life. AMD is increasingly winning against Intel on desktop CPU performance, laptop integrated graphics, and battery life as well, while Intel lays off 15,000 workers as it tries to recover from its major misses. The Steam Deck gaming handheld has shown gamers that Linux could be a real alternative to Windows, while Windows is pushing away power users by disrespecting their choices and trying to sell more Microsoft products to what they think is a captive audience. But the world may not be run by PCs for long. The phone already became the most important computer in most people's lives, and the AI server has now become the most important computer for chip makers to feed. I don't know if I'd enjoy life without dedicated local processing power, but it's not too hard to imagine less PC. Before personal computers, you might log into a dumb terminal connected to a vastly powerful mainframe. Will AI bring us back to those days?
AI labs are going to continue to try to control your devices, also called agents. Anthropic recently introduced a feature that lets its AI autonomously control devices, while Google and OpenAI are reportedly launching agents in the coming months. Still, key challenges remain, including reliability, accessibility, and security. For example, in a demo, Anthropic's agent unexpectedly searched for images of Yellowstone instead of performing its intended task. These features will also likely be subscription-based due to the high operational costs. And security and privacy are also significant concerns, as compromised agents, prompt injections, and data leaks pose substantial risks.
Trump's victory in the election likely signals the end of generous government incentives that helped bring the price of EVs down for millions of Americans. And that means automakers will be faced with a choice. Scrap their plans to build cheaper EVs or double down. Ford's CEO drove Xiaomi's new EV for several months to get a better feel for what makes it so special. But he also said he wanted to understand how China had cracked the code on cheap EVs. American automakers are still struggling to keep up with China's pace, and the elimination of tax credits will be a watershed moment that could drive them back into the arms of polluting gas guzzlers, or to truly innovate and introduce affordable models of their own.
I think we'll see more interest in nuclear energy next year because big tech is obsessed with AI and it's driving up power demand for data centers. Nuclear reactors can generate electricity around the clock without creating greenhouse gas emissions. There are concerns about high costs with nuclear energy, not to mention the environmental impact of mining uranium and storing radioactive waste. But we've already seen Microsoft, Amazon, and Google ink major deals this year to purchase nuclear energy for their data centers. Those energy demands aren't going away, so we might see more of these kinds of deals next year.
So I think DJI drones are about to become a lot more expensive. In 2019, DJI made adjustments to pricing on its products following the increased tariffs on Chinese goods imposed by the Trump administration. The price increased for its Mavic 2 line by about 13%. So we're about to enter Trump's second term, and the ongoing trade war could also just make it harder for consumers to get their hands on said drones. Paired that with the looming ban on DJI, and it's all sounding a bit uncertain what the future for the drone industry in the US will look like. So those are some of the key moments to look out for in 2025. And in case you missed it, we also made a video about our favorite tech from 2024, so be sure to check that out. And we'll still have a few more videos before the end of the year, so stay tuned. And in case I don't see you until next year, I hope 2024 was treating you well, and I hope 2025 treats you even better. Take care. I'll see you all soon.